all, my name is Anushka Siddharth. I am from Bokaro Steel City, Jharkhand. Firstly, I want to thank Step Beyond Borders for inviting me to host this workshop. Step Beyond Borders allow people and interns from all across the globe to come and get to know thoroughly about the Indian culture. I'm so glad that they gave me the opportunity to share my love for food and cooking on this platform. So talking about Indian culture, we cannot miss on food, as food is one of the most prominent part of our Indian culture. So I'm really glad and I am so honorable to start with it. So today, talking about cooking and food, cooking is a passion. It's something that I enjoy doing. I do it because it's a stress buster for me and for a lot of people, I guess. At the age when people were watching Hannah Montana and High School Musical, I used to sit and watch the cookery shows. It's that how much enjoy cooking. So following my passion and my love for cooking, me and my friend Pratisha, we started a page named Peckish with Nush and Tisha. We upload videos of food that we cook at our places and even pictures of food that we eat outside. So all those who are viewing me right now can go visit my page Peckish with Nush and Tisha and do follow if you like my page. So today I'm going to make Paneer Bhurji. Paneer, as you also know, is called cottage cheese. Paneer is one of the most important dish that we use, Indian use in their main cuisine. We use it as a main dish, we use it as a snack, and we also use it as a dessert. So today that's what I'm going to do. Talking about paneer is the most common cheese used in India. It is made by curdling of milk with the help of lemon and vinegar. So we can use it as a healthy way because it gives us protein, and you can use it as a healthy purpose. You can also make it a lavish. Paneer dishes that are commonly made in India is matar paneer, paneer bhurji, paneer butter masala, palak paneer. Even for the snacks, we have paneer pakora, paneer chili, and for dessert, we have rasmalai and rasgulla. So these are the different varieties from that are made from just one item, and that is paneer. So I think we should start with paneer bhurji. Paneer bhurji is a very basic dish, but it's very tasty. And it's very simple, as I have noted the ingredients before only. So it's very easy to make, and plus you can eat, when you are on diet or anything, you can eat paneer bhurji without adding less of masalas and spices. But as an Indian, I think I should add a little bit masala and everything. So I think I should start with making it. So first of all, we'll add oil, 2 tablespoons of oil. And as it heats, okay, so the oil is heated now. We'll add cumin seeds, 1/2 tablespoon. When the cumin starts spluttering, we'll add onions to it. And we have to cook it until it becomes translucent. This will take time. Keep mixing it so that it doesn't burn. Yoga and meditation. Okay, tell us what all you cooked. I cooked samosas. I made a lot of different kind of chicken. I made biryani, which is something I'm obsessed with. Okay, and then I made kind of salads also, and then sweets and everything. So yeah, that's all I cooked. So the onions have become translucent now. Okay, so we'll add ginger garlic paste to it. Hope it's visible. We'll cook the ginger and garlic till the pungent smell of garlic and ginger goes away. Taking some time. I hope you guys are doing well in this time, and people who have joined just now, I will tell you that I'm making paneer bhurji, and I am here because Step Beyond Borders invited me to host this workshop, so I'm really glad to do that. I'm here. Okay, so the ginger and garlic is cooked. Now we'll add tomatoes to it. And as soon as we add tomato, we should immediately add salt, because salt helps in cooking process faster. It makes the tomatoes and all the vegetables mushy easily, that is cooked easily. And as per your taste, you can add people at my place use a bit more salt, so I'm using a bit more salt, but you can use as per your taste. If you're on a diet and you're avoiding salt, then you can totally avoid it, because you can add it, because there are a lot of masalas which will add flavor to it, so it's okay. So because of the salt, it has started to become mushy. So just after that, we'll add the spices, which is turmeric, red chili powder, cumin powder, coriander powder, and black pepper powder. We'll add all of it together and give it a nice mix. We'll add a little bit of water so that the masala do not burn. Disha ma'am is saying eat momos. Oh, even I want to eat momos. I haven't. Momos and golgappes, that are the two things I haven't eaten. So the masalas are cooked. You can smell it. If you get that rawness of the masala, then it means it is not cooked. There are two ways you can see whether the masalas are cooked. First is you'll smell it, and if there is rawness, that means it isn't cooked. And second is the oil starts separating from the masala. So if any one of this is happening, that means your food is cooked. Your masalas are cooked. Just increase the flame so that it cooks faster. Thank you. My mama is here. Thank you for everyone who is motivating me for this. Thank you so much. last because we want to keep the capsicum crunchy. Just we have to just remove the rawness, just the raw smell of it, and it's done. Because overcooked capsicum does not, you know, taste that good. And plus, it saves the nutrition when you cook it less. You should always cook. You know, the food should never be overcooked. Because I just read somewhere that Indians especially tend to overcook their food. To just, you know, I don't know, they just do that. And even I do a lot of times, we overcook it. Office. Yeah, that is what I think I'm gonna start next. Office. As you have only suggested me thousands of times. So I think I'm gonna do that. Mahabharat. Rashi is watching Mahabharat. Okay. Cooking, you'll add just a little bit of garam masala to it, just a little. You'll keep it for the, you know, for last, but use a little bit of it. Okay, I'm surely gonna see that. The YouTube show. Okay. The people who are joining right now, I just want to brief you with what I'm making. I'm making paneer bhurji. And I have added half of the items right now. I've added the onions, the capsicum, tomatoes, and all the spices that are required. And it's almost done. Just briefing you so that you can keep. And don't worry, if you want to, you know, learn this recipe, this video will be of course uploaded on Step Beyond Borders page, so you can see this anytime you want. So the rawness of the onion is gone and the masalas are cooked. So now we are going to add the paneer to it. It is a grated paneer. Mix it properly so that, you know, this paneer and masala blends together and give a nice taste. And all the paneer and masala mix well. So it's mixed now. All the paneer and the masalas are blended properly. So now we are going to add the rest over garam masala to it. Okay. And then we'll add 2 big tablespoons of pav bhaji masala. This is not generally, you know, it is not found in paneer bhurji, but it gives an amazing taste to the paneer. The tangy taste of pav bhaji, and it just tastes very amazing. This paneer bhurji was our go-to dish when we were in hostel. Like, when we do not like hostel food, this was the savior. This was our savior. We used to cook it every time. So as you put the pav bhaji masala, what do you have to do? Just take little bit of water and then you cook. Just a little bit of water, not a lot of it. Again, when it is all blending, you'll again put some water. You have to do this process like 2-3 times so that, you know, your food, all the masalas and paneer are blending together. Paneer paneer bhurji. We are making paneer. I am making paneer bhurji. As paneer is one of the most prominent part of our Indian cuisine. No, our Indian cuisine is not finished without paneer being in it. You can have it in many different ways, as a main dish, as a snack, as a dessert. So tell me, all of you here, what are your favorite food? And tell me, so when Step Beyond Borders will organize more food, they will try to make such things for their audience. So there is enough of water. All the masalas and paneer. It's cooked properly. Now the last thing, second last thing actually, is the green chilies. You do not use it at the last because it gives a nice crunchy chili taste. Butter chicken, okay. Mughlai chicken, sure. It'll be fun making such items. Plus, I am a big time chicken lover, so I'll enjoy making it if I get an opportunity to do so. Although it's a lengthy task, but totally worth it. Chili paneer. Okay, that you have to come here. I thought Rashi will write something else. I thought she's gonna write Litti Chokha. That's fine. So as a paneer bhurji is done, we'll switch off the flame and lastly we'll garnish it with lots and lots of coriander. It gives an amazing taste. You add coriander, anything, and it will taste amazing. So our paneer chili is done. Paneer bhurji is done. You can serve it hot. You can eat it with chapati, naan. Even bread, people you eat it with bun, you know, in parts of Maharashtra, especially in Mumbai, people eat paneer bhurji with bun. It's, and you can eat it with chapati, of course, naan, tandoori roti, and bread. You can, you know, fill in between the two breads and eat it as a sandwich. So yeah, this is it. This was our dish. I had a great time, you know, making this for you. I hope you all enjoyed. Please show the bhurji, okay? I hope it's visible. Okay, so I hope you guys liked the bhurji, and whenever whoever makes it, please take a photo and upload it. And if you upload, please tag Pekish with Nush and Tisha and Step Beyond Borders, so that we get to know that you liked it and you made it. And do follow both Step Beyond Borders and Pekish with Nush and Tisha. We'll be really happy if you make it and upload it. You know, I have heard people adding curd to it. And I think it gives a good taste. Because curd itself is a very good thing. But yummy ingredient. So I think you can eat it. Yeah, sure, Rashi, you can add curd. I have also heard it, that you can add curd. And I think it tastes yummy. Thank you for attending all our sessions. Step Beyond Borders are doing a great job. They are interning people from all over the globe, teaching them about our Indian culture, Indian ethos, and, you know, giving them internship So it's they're doing a great job, and you know, at times like this during pandemic, they are not able to visit India, you know, get to learn about it. So it's a very good opportunity what the initiative they are taking, that reaching to them virtually is a very good thing, and I think they are doing a great job.